Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about restriction fragment length polymorphism, which is also called as RFLP. Now the procedure of restriction fragment length polymorphism. Here we take three samples, in the which two are control sample and the third one is a mutated sample. So when we take this DNA in an up and off tube, to this up and off tube we are going to add restriction enzymes which will cut the DNA at particular sequence. Now this restriction fragments are going to be, restriction fragments from each sample are separated by electrophoresis. Each sample form a characteristic pattern of bands. Now this gel is used for southern blotting. Here the capillary action pulls an alkaline solution upward through gel and through a sheet of nitrocellulose paper laid on the top of it, transferring the DNA to the paper and denaturing it in the process. Single-stranded DNA stick to the paper positioned in the band exactly as on the gel. Next is hybridization with radioactive probe. The paper blot is exposed to a solution containing radioactively labeled probe. The probe is a single-stranded DNA complementary to DNA sequence of interest, and it attached to the base pairing to restriction fragment of complementary sequence. Rinse away unattached probe. Later, autography will be done. Here the sheet of the photographic film is laid over the paper. Radioactivity in the bound probe expose the film to form an image corresponding to the specific DNA bands. The bands containing DNA that base pairs with the probe. The band pattern of sample 1 and 2 are identical, but the third sample is different. In this way, we can identify the mutated sample. First, we will discuss about non-PCR based markers. Under that, first we will discuss about restriction fragment length polymorphism. Here, the variation in the length of DNA fragment produced by specific restriction endonuclease from genomic DNA of two or more individuals of a species are identified. If two individuals differ by as little as single nucleotide in the restriction site, the restriction enzyme will cut the DNA of one but not the other. Restriction fragment of different length are thus generated. Now, where does this restriction fragment length polymorphism is applicable? It is applicable in intraspecific level or among closely related taxa. Presence or absence of fragment resulting from change in recognition site are used for identifying the species or population, estimating genetic distance and fingerprinting, forensic biological percentage, paternity cases, and disease status and genetic mapping.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.